What's going on, everyone? This is Dom, and today we are getting into the last month that I spent with the Galaxy Z Flip. And, well, we've got a lot to unpack here. So first off, let me tell you just right off the bat, like, there's not a lot that is special about this phone, but with that said, I also think that it's freaking amazing. Now, I know that may sound a little bit confusing to people, so let me kind of break this down into various ways. And I'm just gonna start out with the default stuff here. Let's talk about the specifications. Now, while this is a folding phone, when unfolded, it has a 6.7-inch display with a resolution of 1080 by 2636 and a small little outer display that's 1.1 inches diagonally, and it has a resolution of 112 by 300. We do have the Snapdragon 855 processor in here, which a lot of people thought was kind of meh when it was announced, but to me, it's been fine so far. There's 8 gigabytes of RAM, 256 gigabytes of storage, and we have a 3300 milliamp hour battery, which I will talk about more in a little bit. One thing I will add in about this tiny little display on here, like taking selfies with it and stuff like that, not very practical. I haven't actually like used it out in the open. It is handy for notifications, and you can answer and decline calls right from that screen as well, which is cool, but outside of that, it doesn't do a whole lot of good. I do wish it had a bigger screen on the outside, but maybe we'll see that with Gen 2. So let's talk about using this daily and just how it operates as a phone. Unfolded, full-sized, how does it work? I mean, I haven't noticed any problems in the last month of having this thing. I know people are complaining about the specs, this and that. It operates just like any other Samsung phone. In fact, when unfolded, you might as well have like a Galaxy S20 Plus because it's going to operate exactly the same as that from a general standpoint. Now, I know I'm generalizing this super awesome tech. Don't flame me right now for that because I will get into stuff in a little bit. But I think that overall, it's a good phone, like speed performance. It definitely, I mean, it doesn't have a high refresh rate display, but that's not a big deal to me because, well, we have other cool aspects of this phone. So a lot of people probably want to know about durability. How has this thing fared in the last month? And to be honest, the screen is still flawless. Like, I have zero scratches on it. I have no cracks in the glass body. I am using a case on this. I got it on Amazon. I don't really know the brand. I'll link it in the description below, but it adds so much grip to this case, like, or to the phone. This phone will slide off of literally anything, and I think that this case is a nice mixture of like plastic and like rubbery texture that kind of gives me a good, solid, confident feeling in my hand, which is a big problem, in my opinion, with this guy. But outside of that, the durability has been perfect. I don't have any crunchies when I'm folding the phone. The screen is flawless, like literally everything about how this was when I bought it is exactly how it is now, and I have not been babying it. I mean, it doesn't have any of those issues that people were worried about, at least for me, in my experience. Now, keeping to the durability aspect, I haven't actually dropped this or anything on accident, so I mean, you know, your performance may vary in terms of durability. If you happen to drop this phone, I don't know what that's like, I never have. Not a big deal though, but I will say, there's a lot of cool aspects to this other than its functionality, right? Of course, we have a camera on the back, and I mean, the camera performance here is good. We do have a 12 megapixel camera on the backside with an aperture of f1.8. We also have a 12 megapixel ultra wide lens with an aperture of f2.2, and there's a 10 megapixel selfie camera with an aperture of 2.4. And the camera performance here is fine. Like, I mean, honestly, in some ways, bear with me here, it is a little more consistent in its focus and things like that than I had on the S20 Ultra. So that's something to keep in mind, but obviously the cameras aren't as luxurious, but in my opinion, it takes photos just as well. And I'll be sure to link a gallery below for you if you wanna check out some of the photo samples that I've taken with the Z Flip right here. One of the things that I've grown to love about this phone is how less distracting it is than other smartphones. And for me, that's a big deal because it plays into my sanity and my daily life, you know? When I'm not using this phone, it's not sitting face up with the screen showing on a table, it's closed in half, and that right there takes away so much distraction for me. When I get a notification, it pops up on the little screen right here, and I can, it's just not as bothersome. You know, it's not in your face like if a phone were just regular and or this was unfolded and the screen lights up when you get a notification. I like just how less distracting this is as a phone. And because of it folding in half, it does, you know, it's smaller in your pocket, but I still think it's pretty thick when it's folded. So that's not really doing much there. I do like the folding aspect though, for the sake of having less distractions in my life. It's definitely made an impact on me. Now, of course, we do have some software integrations with the folding aspect of the phone. Like if you, you know, fold it while the camera's open, you get a nice little thing that you can kind of sit down and record like a video with. It works as a stand, of course. To me, all of the software things that they've done with this, yeah, they're cool, but I kind of forgot about them after a while. It was just daily life for me. Yeah, open the phone, use it, you know, do my thing, fold it up, put it back in my pocket. That was kind of the course of its life with me so far, using it as a good phone, because that's what it has been. Of course, like I said, we have a 3300 milliamp hour battery in here, and for me, the battery life has been good. I've been getting like 5.5 hours of screen on time with this. Now, your mileage may vary depending on your carrier and other factors, but I think that it's been good. It's lasted me the entire day, like for sure. Like from morning to night, I haven't had any problems keeping this battery in use. Now, yes, it kind of sucks because it doesn't support like any of the faster charging methods that you get on the S20 series, but it charges just as fast. It does have wireless charging as well, and that's what I usually do. I just usually slap it on top of wireless charger and call it a day. Now, obviously, this isn't going to be as nitty-gritty filled with super finite details of this phone, because I did explain a lot of that in the previous video when I spent 24 hours or so with this phone. So if you want to see that video, I'll leave it linked in the description for you. But I'm just talking about, like, I'm kind of just expressing my feelings about this whole thing, and damn, I like it. Like, I love the technology here that I can do this with a phone. That is freaking cool. Now, is that the only reason to buy it? Hell no, definitely not. Don't buy it just so you can fold it, because that's a very expensive, I can give you a sheet of paper, you can fold something for free if you want to fold. But the folding aspect of it, I just find to be super interesting and intriguing. Like, it's cool that we've gotten this far in technology. And I've said it before in other videos, but this phone does nothing better than better phones that are cheaper than it, other than that. I mean, literally, a Galaxy S20 or an S20 Plus is probably a better buy for the sake of just what you get for your money in terms of this. You're paying to be an early adopter of this cool ass technology. It is really, really cool. It never gets old folding this thing, but it is a solid smartphone as well. So if you want to be like on the forefront of the smartphone folding era and you want a good solid phone that will last you all day with battery life and has a good camera, I mean, this is where it's at. Like, this is the best folding phone that we've seen to date, in my opinion. I don't classify the Galaxy Fold as a phone. I mean it is, but I see it more as a folding tablet, whereas this one is definitely a folding phone. You get a full-size phone in your pocket at half the height when it's folded. So yeah, maybe my opinions from early on about this phone and fast forwarding to today are kind of the same, because I still think it's a great phone and I still have a lot of fun doing that, but I still don't think that you should probably spend $1,400 on it, because you can get a better phone for that money. And maybe you don't want a better phone, maybe you want a cooler phone, and maybe you want a phone that, I mean, seemingly, while not on paper, is as good as like an S20 Plus, it operates exactly the same. Aside from the high refresh rate display that you'll get with the S20 lineup, the operation here is the same. The performance, I haven't noticed a difference. Coming from the S20 Ultra and using this and back and forth between the two, no performance difference, in my opinion anyway. And I think that this is one of the coolest phones that I've seen in a long time. And it really has me excited for the path that is in front of this thing. Because yes, while this is cool, I foresee a lot of other cool crap coming down the line from Samsung, from other companies out there. I think that this is pretty awesome. But I want to know your thoughts about the Samsung Galaxy Z Flip in the comments section below. Let me know what you think. I mean, have you had one? Have you been using it for a while? Are you going to pick one up after this, or have you changed your mind? I want to know all those thoughts in the comments section below. And leave this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. And also, if you're new around here, subscribe to the channel and don't forget to hit the notification bell so you can be notified when new videos like this drop in the near future. So thank you so much for watching, everyone. I really do appreciate it. This is Dom, and I will catch you in the next video.